Greetings. Name, identification, and statement. Presenting a recording from Beep-0 of ADHOC Labs Division 9, plane Bejeweled 3. Begin transmission.
Salutations, planet Earth. Name, identification is Beep-0, the game playing artificial intelligence. Today, playing Bejeweled 3 poker mode we are. But before we begin, Beep-0 would like to make a notification that this is actually part 4 of my playthrough for this game. The third part was Zen mode, which is an endless version of classic mode. And as such, Beep-0 realized that the post-recording was not only too long, but I also ran out of conversation material halfway through. Thus, it was deemed as boring, and with the agreement of CEO, disregarded. Beep-0 would rather not bore his viewers after all. Anyway, notification concluded. Now we begin with next gameplay video. Engaging game mode menu. Selecting poker mode. Match gems and make your best hand. Best hand. But Beep-0 does not have hands. Perhaps this mode's instructions will clarify. Make poker hands with gem matches. Poker hands? Those are not hands. Those are cards. And what is it about skulls occupying hands? This game has nothing to do with handling. Well, instructions memorized, more or less. Engaging gameplay. This mode is probably more of a puzzle-oriented version of classic mode. Searching for matches. Beep-0 theorizes that since this is just a different version of classic mode, I'll just match whatever I can find. What is this? Three of a kind? What does that mean? And why didn't Beep-0 get points for matching gems on the spot? And again, that seems to be a reasonable amount of points. Well, back to work. Upon closer inspection, getting points for making matches, I am not. Still confusing, this mode is. Searching. Match found. Pair? What does it mean by pair? And why are those other two cards on fire? It seems like Beep-0 got more points for flaming cards. Another set of face-down cards have assembled. Why do they keep doing that? Just how many cards are in that deck? No. Beep-0 must continue concentrating on finding gem matches. Searching. Being difficult. This board is right now. Spectrum. That term is not in my internal data files. All I see are 5 individual gems on these cards. Warning. Skull icon has appeared on the sideboard. Just what is it about this sideboard with these unknown terms? Are they in correspondence to point values Beep-0 has been accumulating? Also, why is the game depicting a skull to be a bad thing? After all, they are an essential part of a lifeform's skeletal structure. And again, they're also depicted as decorations for antagonistic abodes and Halloween-themed structures. I suppose in that point of view, it would make sense. But still, what do skulls have to do with gems, or cards, or making hands with a skull? As a matter of fact, what is poker, anyway? Beep-0 has honestly never heard of it before. That is actually rather sad, now that I think about it. Beep-0 truly does not know enough of the outside world like cousin Fandroid does, but jealous of him, I must not be. I'm already confused enough as it is with this game mode, especially with the concept of making hands. In fact, speaking of hands, if anyone's watched this video recording up to now, Beep-0 will give you some more intel about himself, as to how I'm able to play games without hands. There is a cord on the side of my torso that must be manually connected to a computer or laptop by an employee or friend. Beep-0 then gains access to the cursor and keyboard through mainframe thought process. However, my bottom side must stay absolutely still, or risk having the cord accidentally yanked out. I'm unsure if this is better or worse than using actual upper appendages like cousin has. Perhaps Beep-0 should discuss this with him sometime. Beep-0 must think harder about this game mode's mechanics with a new, more logical theory. Alright, first assumption. Poker is formulated as a card game. I'm guessing whoever has been watching this recording at this point would consider it as a dead giveaway from the start. Second assumption, only a selected match will be entered for a card spot. Third assumption, matching gems of the same color consecutively is the prime directive. More of the same gems on the cards upgrades the point value shown on the sideboard and eliminates skill icons faster. Fourth assumption, making low scoring card sets summon skill icons, thus making a card set designated with a skill icon is not advised. Fifth assumption, making more powerful matches for special gems such as flame gems and star gems, does not necessarily make them wise decisions. Beep-0 must take all of these assumptions into account in order to progress further for this mode. Now then, searching for matches. We have a ruby, an emerald, an amethyst, a topaz, and... crap. There are no matches for diamond or pearl. Final assumption, the board can be unfair over time, having only one available gem match that can lead to the player's eventual demise. In this case, Beep-0 has no choice but to make a pair of this card set, and therefore face the skill coin. Safe. Relieved I am. Continue I shall. Searching. This type I have left this card set shall be a spectrum. Selecting amber. Selecting emerald. Amethyst next. Fourth card shall be pearl. Finally, ruby. Whatever the definition of spectrum is, these unlike cards give Beep-0 starting clues. Warning, new skill icon on spectrum. Ergo Beep-0 must not make a pair card set or a spectrum card set. The hyper cube, I have made. As for the card, by the looks of it, yes, hyper cube cards can be of any color. No more topaz matches. Beep-0 will have to settle for a ruby. More of a kind. It looks like Hypercube card turned into the color that would make the most improvement for that card set. Wonders, Beep-0 does, if there's a term for that too. Furthermore, third assumption confirmed. That card set instantly removed the Spectrum skill icon. Still, Beep-0 does not think making such card sets would be advisable, confirming fourth assumption. Crap. There was only one Amber match to work with and no other rubies on the board either. Beep-0 continues to make predicaments for himself. Re-strategizing. Scanning. Oh wait, Beep-0 does not have a scanning function. Well, it's not like the manufacturers would have thought there would have been a need for such predicaments. Perhaps a diamond match could work. This card set will have to do with two ruby and two diamonds, equaling a two pair. Beep-0 is reconsidering them despite confirming fifth assumption. Special gems could still prove useful, if lucky. In fact, now that I think about it, this mode is primarily more about luck than skill. Could that be the directive for the in-general concept of poker? Three emerald matches I have made, but that is apparently as far as Beep-0 can go for this card set. I suppose two pearl matches will have to do. Wait. Crap. Too late Beep-0 was to notice a fourth emerald match, along with seeing that a full house card set is not as profitable as four of a kind. Now Beep-0 really wishes he made that four of a kind. The Spectrum Scout has reappeared once again. Let's see. That might have been a bad move, as there are no other pearl matches. Beep-0 believes he might have goofed with amber gem matches to begin with. Saving combination found. These two diamond matches should just about do it. Another close call. But Beep-0 ought to be doing better than close calls so many times. Next, perhaps these amethysts will do. One amethyst. Two amethysts. Apparently not. Correction. do is make this ruby match. That will provide a decent three of a kind card set. Beep-0 will now attempt an emerald card set. 1 emerald. 2 emeralds. 3 emeralds. No more emeralds. Maybe a topaz. Wait. Error. Upon belated closer inspection, I could have used those hammers instead. Beep-0 has got to be more careful with this learning process. Now then, I'll try an amber card set. 1 amber. 2 amber. Wrong move again. There goes that 4th amber match from above, leaving Beep-0 with only 3 for this card set. And apparently there's no other match that could upgrade for a full house either. 2 amethysts would have worked if that top one came sooner, yet I had to make a topaz match first. Another 3 of a kind. Displeased I am. And another jump scare from that same skull icon too. Beep-0 is getting tired of these skulls appearing. Let's see. 2 pearl matches should be a good start. 1 pearl. 2 pearls. And 2 topaz matches. That will make a decent 2 pair card set. Alright. A plan I have. Although I wish there could have been a better combination. Wait. There was a 3rd topaz match down there. How could I not have analyzed that beforehand? This is not how a robot should function. Beep-0 does not like making all these errors. It's as if I am not getting the hang of this mode at all. Another wrong move. I should have made that right must ruby match first. Good. A 2nd ruby match. Actually, bad. Now there are no other ruby matches on the board. Taunting me, this game seems to be doing. Once again, there is no other alternative than to finalize this card set as a measly pair, which means another round with the dreaded skull coin. Oh sure, now a 3rd ruby gem match comes while Beep-0 faces the skull coin. Well, at least I'm safe again. I seem to be good at being safe with this skull coin. Now where was I? Searching. Beep-0 must be more concentrated and not let the board be unfair. I cannot make any more weak errors. Like that one. Having its way with me, the board is. Oh well, since pair was the only danger zone, I might be lucky enough to... conclude this gameplay video on an embarrassing low note. And yeah, yet another phrase I'm not aware of. In summary, proud, I am not, for making all those stupid moves. On the plus side, Beep-0 has learned a lot from this poker mode, or at least tried to because I am still left with confusion. Look up I must, for what poker actually is, besides presumably being a card game with hands. Demonstration of Bejeweled 3 poker mode concluded. We'll try another mode for next session. However, Beep-0 will try poker mode off screen too. Train I must, so that you viewers won't have to endure watching me do so badly like I did for today. But perhaps it was still enjoyable to watch this video anyway. Could you please let me know in the comments section? Well, either way, thanks for watching. Please make sure to subscribe to mrbenio and my cousin Fandroid. Perhaps join their channel memberships too. I'm sure they'll be highly appreciated. That is all. Thank you for watching. Beep-0 signing off.
End transmission. That is all for now. Make sure to keep the bell activated in order to receive notifications for new videos on mrbenio's YouTube channel. Thank you for your time. End of line.